Actually, aim of the Ayurveda doctor is to give you quality health service. So quality health service means the quality patient. One of the chickens are the spots. And this is the problem. And potent and ever cure the disease. How we can get the potent carb and pure carb is by this scientific collection of medicinal plants. In general, how to understand the scientific collection? As we know, due to the excessive use of the medicinal plants, in the wild population of the medicinal plant is depleting. To stop that, what we have to follow the scientific method of collection. For example, while collecting the bark as a part of the medicinal plant, we should collect only peel the bark of the plant, but not to cut the tree as a whole. If we cut, we will get bark for one time only. But if we peel off the bark, then it will regenerate by nature and we can get it for the next time use also. So, while talking about the adulteration is the mixing of materials other than the medicinal plant which is low in quality. Normally adulteration, we can see in the nature, like in the case of resin. By nature only there are many dust, insects and other materials attached to the resin. But when we see in the market, the reason for adulteration is the high demand of the drugs which are not available in the market. For example, kesar, which is not available in the market, but people are selling like kushumba in the name of kesar in the market. And the next is the scarcity of the genuine drug in the market. For example, shankha pushpi, original source is Karmal Bolus pluricaus, but in the South India, they are using aparajita in the name of shankha pushpi. And types of adulteration is specially two types, intentional and unintentional. Intentional, by the word, we know that businessmen or the traders, they will mix other substances with the genuine drugs to get the profit. But when we talk about the unintentional, and which is the basic source of adulteration during the collection, that's why I choose the topics, because mostly the collectors of the medicinal plants are the layman or the community people who don't have the detailed knowledge of the medicinal plants, parts use of the plant. That's why the unintentional adulteration is also one of the cause for the depletion of the quality of herbal product. That can be categorized into three types. For example, a small other herb collected during the collection of the medicinal plant. For example, when we collect the manduka parnu, there are many small herbs or insects or dust particles along the manduka parnu. As we have not given training to the people, they will not pluck the leaf of the manduka parnu. They will just collect it randomly. During that time, all those materials around the plant will come together. That comes under the unintentional collection of adulteration during the collection of medicinal plants. What is the effect of adulteration? As we know, nowadays we are listening that under the profession or the herbal medicines are not working properly or they are not fast acting. It means lack of optimum benefit of the drugs and then increased dose requirement and the delayed function or the reduced effect of the herbal. So WHO has given one guideline for the scientific collection of the medicinal plants. For example, we should collect only the healthy plants, because in the same flora we will get infested plant and the healthy plant. But we should avoid create the awareness to the collectors to collect only the healthy plants. You can see here the insect is the gunimba, andrographis paniculata, and it is a healthy plant of the gunimba. It should be created awareness to the people to collect only the healthy plant. And the next is mixing of foreign material and toxic during collection should be avoided. For example, we know that mostly 70 to 80% of our raw drugs are coming from the wild habitat. There may be the fecal material of the wild animals and all those things. If that is being mixed with the raw drug, then the medicine will give some toxic effect. So we should avoid that. And the next is the botanical identity of the genuine source. For example, Nag Keshara, the genuine source being the Meshwar Feria. Mostly in the market we can get the Sarapur Naga. That is the Acrocarpus longiformis. Now my conclusion from all these things. As nowadays we are talking about the globalization of Ayurveda. For that we need the sustainable resources of the herbal plant for the quality herbal product. for the sustainable sources in the conservation of the medicinal plants by the scientific collection of the medicinal plants. For that, we should provide a regular training for proper and scientific collection of the medicinal plants. There are many points, but I have just brought few important points. Only 70-80% of the plants should be collected from the certain periphery. And if it is a vegetative part like flower, fruit, seeds, we should collect only 60% of those, and rest should be left in the wild habitat for the regeneration, so that next year it will come and we can again use for the medicinal purpose. And the right type of collection of medicinally important plant parts. Now it is very burning issue. There are many research work going on in that. Because what happens, collecting people, they will just go to the jungle. They will get and collect it. They will not see what is the maturity of the plant. Due to that, chemical percentage of the active chemical constituent will be very, very less. And we need high dose of medicine or the effectiveness of the medicine. We will reserve that issue also. We should train the people for the proper consumption of the medicinal plants. And as we know, quality of herbal products should be fast acting, should be able to cure the disease in the minimum dose and contain maximum amount of active constituent. And that is possible in the genuine raw materials, free of chemicals. Finally, my conclusion is all these things have to maintain environmental as well as animal ecosystem, the main theme of the 7th World Ayurveda Conference. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.